So we hear the IDTechEx show, and who are you?
I'm Tom Rindelat from UK Cable Corporation. We manufacture and design flat flexible shielded cables.
So you have these special cables here?
Yes, and they look like this. So I store them in a hat because hat is a good place to store things.
Yeah.
So it's a...
This is the cable?
This is the cable.
Like, what can I do, USB or something?
Well, you can do it also USB, but it's for high power or high signal quality applications, depending on your desires. But
this is flexible, no?
This is flexible, yeah.
Flexible and stretchable?
Yeah. No, not stretchable, but flexible.
Okay.
170 microns thick. It's really thick. And this is our standard cable. It has a standard connector footprints and standard length of 300 millimeters, 500 millimeters, 10 millimeters. So
it's only for power, not for data? Or?
That's for data.
Data?
Yes. And for our definition, data is for 1 amp or less per trace.
How many traces in there?
In this cable, 16. And we also work with high power applications. So cable this size is, we are now delivering cables of 20 amps to automotive industry. So they are OEM cables, and we design the cables for automotive.
And you have some different shapes here, some different sizes, or?
Yes, and we also have the connector. I will show. This one is a connector.
Yeah.
And
the connector in the middle of the cable.
It's the middle of, it's connecting two cables, yeah. It's connecting two cables. And that connector is manufactured with the same machines and same materials and same properties than our cables. So it's not external component. We manufacture it with the cable manufacturing devices.
All in one go?
Yes.
What's the manufacturing procedure?
We have in the wall, we have an illustration of this thing.
Yes.
We have different layers. So we start with a PET foil, a substrate, where we have a copper. We etch the copper. Then we will screen print insulator over that. And then we will screen print shielding on both sides of the cable. Top and bottom.
So that's then, all these layers in one go?
Yes, or? Yes, one go. And then magic starts. So we do the we do holes, and we do vias, and we connect top and bottom to the two outer traces of the copper layer. And then, because that's boring, then we just put the print the cover layers in top and bottom of the cable. And we screen print the graphics for the user.
So you said the magic part you put on each side, the step before, what is that?
Magic part is the connections. So we will connect the top shielding to this outer trace and to bottom shielding. And we do it in one process.
In one process?
This is done in one process.
Seven
layers in one process.
Flat,
flexible.
You say micron?
170 microns.
And
it's our standard cable. If you want it to be thinner, we do an OEM cable.
Do you have your cables in there? Or?
Yes, we already delivered into automotive industry, but I have an example here what it would like. So we have replaced in this car, this is RC car, we have replaced all these round cables, which you can see here, with the flat cables. And these cables with the connectors weigh 24 grams. And all these green flat cables, they in total, they weigh 1 gram.
What do you say?
1 gram.
One?
1 gram.
So it's 24
grams, 1 gram.
That's a big deal.
It's a big deal. For example, if you are working on drones, it's a big issue.
Yeah.
When we scale this up to bigger cars, a regular car has a harness about 50 kilos of cable, and we can manufacture that with a 7 kilos of weight.
Because it's such a low weight, does that make it also resistant to all kinds of shocks and everything, because it's not a lot of weight to move around?
No, actually, these perform better. Because of the thickness of the cable, the heat is getting out better from the cable. So we can run higher current, higher power through the cable than from the round cable.
And more vibrations?
And vibrations are not a problem because...
Not a problem.
Not a problem, yeah, on this one.
And what other issues people have? Let's say when people make a rocket,
yep,
like the Falcon Heavy, or when they make the Airbus airplanes.
Yep.
Is this good for that?
Yes. If we say 1 kilogram in Airbus airplane weight in cabling, it means that it will save 20 tons of kerosene in the lifetime of the airplane.
How much does that cost?
1 kilo of kerosene is about 32 cents.
Okay, so it's just about $320,000
yep.
per kilo?
Yeah.
I'm just joking.
Just for 1 kilo.
Yeah.
And if you think about airplane, how much there is cabling? I'm not able to tell the exact number, but let's assume that there are several tons of cabling. And if we save 70% of the weight, and each kilo will save 20 tons of kerosene during the lifetime of airplane, it's a lot.
So every Airbus A320 Neo, if they use your cables, could be saving around $20 or $30 million. I'm joking. I don't know if that's true, but it could be.
Well, I think your figure is a bit wrong. It should be closer to 70 or 90 million.
$70 or $90 million?
Yes.
So why is not everybody buying this right now? Are you mass production?
We are now going to mass production, yes, on the Sunrun cable. And it's always, well, because we are now talking about flat cable. It's a bit different than a round cable.
It's wide.
It's wider, but it's not thinner.
They can fit that in all the designs?
Yes, and this change of paradigm changes things because it requires new tools. Well, it requires new software tools for the engineers to work with. They don't have the tools in their toolbox yet how to cope with these flat cables because they have been working with the round cables. And for example, the bending radius of round cables, it was higher. So it means that I'm not able to bend the round cable like this. Round cable will break. And in here, it's just regular use for this cable.
So you can bend it so tightly and there's no problem?
Yep, like this.
And what does that mean? All the data and all the power goes through?
Yes.
Data and power?
Yes.
That's all you need, right?
Yes. And because we have the shielding, which is protecting from our applications from outside radio frequencies, and it's also guaranteeing that our application does not disturb the other applications. For example, in hospital environment, if you have a apparatus which works with this cable, it does not disturb the other applications around. So people don't suffer in that sense.
You have meetings with Airbus?
Yes.
With all the car companies?
Yes. No, not all. There are so many car companies in the world, but we have...
Is there any Finnish car company?
Not anymore. In Finland, we do some subcontracting of Mercedes, but we don't have any more models of our own yet.
So there has to be a problem, right? Yes. Something. What is the problem? There's nothing wrong?
Problem is sales.
It's not so cheap?
No, but it's hard to find the right person to make a decision. Because idea is good, product is solid, but because we are working with disruptive technology, we are replacing the existing chains of action. So in traditional car harness, there are at minimum 4 companies. One company making the connectors, one company making the round cables, one company making these things which you hang the harness to, and then the fourth company putting it all together to create a harness. And in our case, all that happens in one machine, in one location, in one process.
It's disruptive.
It's disruptive.
But it has to be reliable. The cables are very important.
Yes.
If one cable breaks, it's very hard to find out which cable, where,
yeah,
fix it.
Yes.
So you have to make 100%
yes,
guarantee that everything works.
Yes.
Do you have this or no?
Yes.
You have it?
Yes.
So why is it not like a no-brainer?
And backup solution is that because it's a very thin cable, we can put adhesive tape, for example, in the background. And that's the installation media. And if something is wrong with this cable, if it's flat, we can put another cable on top of that.
So you can have a backup cable?
Yeah, and you can just put it over that first one and replace, just connect the new cable to the existing ones. And it works.
It works.
Yeah, because we are still in very thin layers and weight reduction is so high that even two layers of this cabling is not a problem.
Is copper?
Yeah, we are using copper as a conductor.
Is that the standard for cables?
Yes.
Everybody uses copper?
Yes.
But there's some fiber optic cables also.
Yeah, when you use optical cables, yeah.
Is there fiber optic cables in airplanes and rockets or not?
Yes, there are.
But that's different.
Yeah, but it depends on the application. There, it's more complex issue. I should not open that box of solutions. Yeah.
That's a different market.
Yeah, but it's a complex thing. So we can also install here optical fibers in our cables.
You can do that?
Yes, of course.
Well, not so flat.
Well, with the optical fibers, we are still talking about 40 micrometers thickness, and our cable, the total thickness is 170 microns. So 40 microns is, because we have a 35 micron copper layer, and the optical fiber is 40 microns. So it's not that big difference.
So I've seen you before at the show, right?
Yep.
And it's called Delectre?
We have two companies here.
What is the Delectre?
Delectre, my colleague will tell you about Delectre, what we're doing. Yeah. But
so because what were you doing the previous years you were showing?
We have been showing work of Delectre anyway. For example, we have been talking about the airship. That's one project which I want to show.
Yeah, you want to show it?
And my colleague will talk about those things. Yeah. But I can show it.
It's behind the glass there?
Yes. Yeah. We have this model of airship. That will show the shape of the airship, which we have is one project which we are still going forward with. So the airship is 1 kilometer long.
What?
1 kilometer long. It's like this.
What?
The airship. Yeah, you remember Zeppelin?
Are you talking about what do you call those hydrogen balloons? Or
yes.
Those kinds of things.
Yeah, it's like Zeppelin. Yeah.
Like the Zeppelin.
Yes, but this is Zeppelin in new form.
This is a Zeppelin design.
Yes.
So.
But it's 1 kilometer long.
But it's not real.
No, this is a small scale, but the actual airship is 1 kilometer long. And
the one when it could be done.
Yes.
So what will be the advantage of that?
Because with the printed etherics, we make engines without any moving parts. So in basically, when this hull is 1 kilometer long, we have 2.5 square kilometers of solar panel, which we can print. So it's printed etherics. We have there 5 square kilometers battery, which we will make with printed electrics. The electrical output of that solar panel is matching for city of 70,000 people for one airship.
So the idea is to do renewable energy with this.
Yes.
It's not for flying the airship itself.
Because it travels 700 kilometers per hour.
What?
700 kilometers per hour.
Is fast?
Yes.
Like an airplane?
Yes. Airbus is traveling 850.
But how can it be fast? It's like a one-kilometer device.
We have all the top and bottom layer is engine. So with the printed electronics, we manufacture engines which have no moving parts.
Because the Zeppelin was very slow.
Yes.
But you're not...
This is really high speed. So we have all the top and bottom layer of outside of this is an engine. It's a printed foil with engine.
So how are you going to make it?
We have been showing that off in a couple events now, how we actually do it. And now we're looking we are looking also funding, but because nobody has so far doesn't give us enough funding, we will fund it ourselves.
If this can be so fast, how many passengers can you have on it?
It can take 1,000 tons of cargo.
That's a lot of people.
You can do the math from there. How much do you want to calculate per person? 100 kilos or... But you can have a real nice sofas and tables and furniture there.
So this could be the Airbus 1000, A1000, right?
Yep.
Because the 380 is...
Yes.
Okay, cool. Can we talk about the...
And my colleague will tell you more about the ring.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.